शास्त्र चैप्टर टू मंडप विधान लेसन वन वी आर रिकॉर्डिंग चैप्टर टू इन सम बुक्स इट्स कॉल्ड नाट्य मंडपम In some books it is called Mandapa Vidhanam. In some books it is called Prekshagraha Lakshanam. So whatever be the chapter, it deals with the stage. So we'll do the first 11 slokas. The first sloka number 1. Bharatasya vachaha shrutva prapachir munayah tataha bhagavan shrutumichyamo yajanam rangasam shreyam Bharatasya vachanam shrutva After listening to Bharata's words, Prapachuhu questioned, Munayaha Tataha. Then the Munis asked him, because he was, Bharata was talking to 46 Munis as I told you in chapter 1. So they asked him, Bhagavan, O God, Srotimichyama, we want to hear, listen to, Yajanam Rangasamstrayam. What is the kind of puja that is related to stage? So that is Ranga Samstrayam regarding to related to the stage. Yajanam means puja, worship. What is it? Question number one. Question is not complete. It goes into the second course, second sloka. Sloka number two. Adhava ya kriyas tatra lakshanam yachya pujanam bhavishyat bihi naraihi karyam kadham tanatya veshmani. So also tell us Ya kriyas tatra, what are the activities, what are the kind of rituals that they have to do, lakshanam, their characteristic, their way of worship, etcha pujanam bhavishyat bihi naraihi, in the future generations how human beings will have to do this, karyam kadham tan natya veshmane means auditorium. So what is the kind of worship associated with it? How is it done? What human beings in future will do? How will they do? Please let us know. The question is still not complete. Question goes to third verse. Ihadir natya yogasya natya mandapa yavahi tasmat tasyeva tavattvam lakshanam vaktum arhasi. See, what is most important for a dance or drama? Stage. So, natya yogasya natya mandapa yavahi. For the performance of natya, what is important is natya mandapa. He means, absolutely, verily, definitely. So, natya mandapa mayavahi natya yogasya, it's very important. That's what they say. Tasmat, therefore, tasyaiva tavattvam lakshanam vartum arhasi. Therefore, we want you to let us know what is the lakshanam of the performance. What is the lakshanam of the stage? That we want to know. That is shloka number 3. These three questions, these three verses deal with the questions. The fourth deals with the answer. Brahma, Teshantu Vachanam Sritva, Munina, Bharato, Abravit, Lakshanam, Pujanam Chaiva, Sriyatam, Natya Veshmanaha. Teshantu Vachanam Sritva, listening to their words, Muninam, of the Munis, Bharataha, Abravit, Bharata said, Lakshanam, he is talking about the characteristics of the stage, Pujanam, the worship. Suryatam Natya Veshmani. Of the Natya Veshma, I mean Natya Veshma's auditorium, about the auditorium, its characteristics and the way that puja has to be done, please listen to that. He says that and then goes to shloka number 5. Divyanam Manasi Srishtihi Gurheshu Upavaneshu Cha Yada Bhava Abhinirvartyaha Sarve Bhavastu Manushaha. This is in the bracket. Naranam yatnatah karya lakshanabhita kriya. See, this For the gods, if they just think of it, if they say, you know, it's like a magic, if they think of it, they want this size, this shape, this much auditorium we want, means it will appear in front of them within minutes. Divyanam manasi srishtihi. They'll create it from the mind. Either whether it is houses or gardens, ugraheshu, upavaneshu, whatever they want. Yada bhava abhirnirvartya sarve bhavastu manasa. So what human beings should do is they have to imagine, they have to think, they have to plan. Bhava means feel, think. Sarve bhavastu manasa. They also have to see whether there is anything available like that. Go study it, do research on it. And then naranam yatnataha. Yatnataha naranam for human beings. Yatnataha by making effort only they can do. So they have to do what are the lakshanas, what does the books say, how anybody else has created. They have to go through all that. That is shloka number 5. Suryatam tadyadha yatra kartavyo natyamandapha tasya vastucha pujacha yadha yojyaha prayatnataha. Therefore, please listen to me. Suryatam means please listen to me. How it should be done, where it should be done, and what is the vastu puja according to that. So we need to tell you how it should be done. How should an auditorium should be constructed, where it should be constructed, and what kind of vastu is to be there. That is shloka number 6. Vishwakarma, how he makes the kinds of types of auditoriums is said in 7 and 8 and 9, 10 and 11. So, we will now go to shloka number 7. Iha prakshagruham drishtva dhimata vishwakarmana trividaha sannivesascha shastrataha parikalpitaha. Vishwakarma, who is by himself endowed with the knowledge of construction, he thought about how it should be and what kind of shastram, what kind of science it should follow, and created through three different, trividaha sannivesha, three options, three kinds of shapes. Parikalpita, he imagined and he instituted three kinds of shapes of stages. Shloka number 7. Please understand, this is all at the time when we are not having lights, air conditioners, sound systems. So if there is a stage, it has to be seen by everybody. The last man in the auditorium should be able to see it and hear it. So keep that in mind when you understand these shlokas. Shloka number 8. So he made three types of auditoriums, and the three are defined in the shloka number 8. Vikrushtascha chaturasrascha trascha chaivata mandapaha tesham trini pramanane jastam majyam tadha avaram. So there are three given in the first line. Vikrushtascha, rectangle, chaturasrascha, square, trasrascha, triangle, mandapaha. So there are three kinds of mandapas: rectangular, square and triangle. Tesham, again, among them, trini pramanani. There are three different kinds among them. Jastam is the largest. Madhyam is middle size. Tatha avaram is smaller size. So we have three different shapes and three different sizes. Shapes are rectangle, square, triangle. Sizes are large, medium, small. So that is shloka number 8. Shloka number 9 divides them again according to their sizes. It specifies the sizes. Pramanam esham nirdishtam. Pramanam esham nirdishtam. Hastadanda samashtritam. Samashtrayam. Shatamcha ashtau chatushashtihi astadvatrimshadevacha. Pramanam esham nirdishtam. Hastadanda samashtrayam. Shatamcha ashtau chatushashtihi astadvatrimshadevacha. The quantity by the pramanam by the measurement nirdishta meti specified. What is the measurement? Hasta danda samacharyam. It is measured by the hastas. We don't have tapes and scales at that time. So hastam is, it taken as 1.5 feet. The details will be given in shlokas number 13 and 14. We'll have to wait until that. But I can give you here, the hasta definition is 1.5 feet. Danda is 4 hasta, that is 6 feet. Hasta danda samastre. So, shatancha astau chatushashti hasta dvatrimcha devacha. So now the three sizes are chatamcha shatancha astau. That means 108. Shatam is 100, ashtav is 8. Chatushashti is 60, chatuh is 4, chatushashti means 64. Dvatrimshadevacha is 32. So 108 is the largest, 108 hastas. That means 1.5 into 108. And then chatushashti is 64. And 32 is the smaller one. So these are the measurements. 108 hastas is the largest, 64 hastas is the middle size, 32 is the smaller. So that is shloka number 9. Shloka 10 also give the same thing. Astadhika shatam jastam chatushashtistu madhyamam kaniyasu tada veshma hasta dvatrimshadishyate. The 108 one is the largest, chatushashtistu madhyamam, the 64 is the middle level, kaniyasu, the smaller one, is dvatrimshadishyate, 32. So these are the measurements. These are jasta, madhyama, and kaniyasa, or avara, he says in shloka number 8. And then the last shloka is 11th one. It says, for whom large one, for whom the middle one, for whom the smaller one. Devanam tu bhavet jastam, rupanam madhyamam bhavet, sheshanam prakrutinam tu kaniyam samvidhiyate. It is defined, it is prescribed, that for the gods, the largest, for the kings, the middle level, and for the rest of them, the smaller one. This is how people should employ them. That is shloka number 11. This is the first lesson. Good morning. We'll start from the 12th. Here, Bharata begins with what are the details of the stage. Pramanam yachya nirdishtam lakshanam vishvakarmana preksha gruhanam sarvesham tachayi vinibhodata. This is the 12th verse. But before that, there are three verses which are given in the brackets, which we'll just go through and summarize all the three together. These are given like this because they are considered to be interpolations by some authors. So the three which do not have numbers are these three shlokas. Preksha gruhanam sarvesham prasastam madhyamam smritam taktra pachyancha gayancha sukhasravyataram bhavet. Out of the preksha gruhanam sarvesham, out of all the auditoriums, prasastam, the best, is madhyamam smritam. The middle level, the medium kind of an auditorium is the best because tatra there, pachyancha gayancha, whatever is the text can be, or the lyric can be sukhasravyataram bhavet, comfortably you can hear. So that is the first interpolated shloka in the brackets. The second one is preksha gruhanam sarvesham triprakaro vidismritah vikrushtachya chaturastrachya tarashchachyaiva prayoktribihi. This is a repetition almost. Preksha gruhanam sarvesham, after all the auditoriums, three prakaro bhavet. Three means three. Three different types. Vidismritaha. These are three types. Vikrushtachya, rectangle. Chaturastrachya, square. Tarashchachyaiva is the triangle. So this is the second shloka in the bracket. The third one is kaniyastu smritam trashyam chaturastrantu madhyamam jastam vikrushtam vigyayam natyaveda prayokti bihi. This is a kind of a shloka which is considered sometimes a controversial sloka because it says the smallest stage is triangular in size, the middle level stage is square in size, and the bigger, largest one is the rectangular one. Kaniyastu is smaller one, Trashyam, that means triangular. Chaturastram is Madhyam, square is the middle level. Jastam means of all these one, biggest. Vikrushtam is rectangle. These are the three slokas we should study before we study the 12th sloka. 12th sloka again. Pramanam yachya nirdishtam lakshanam vishvakarmana preksha gruhanam sarvesham tachayivahi nibodata. Now, whatever nirdishtam prescribed lakshanam, characteristics, by vishvakarma, vishvakarmana, pramanam, the standards, prakshagruhanam sarvesham of all the auditoriums, tachayiva nibodata. Please know those details. Know now the details and the prescribed by vishvakarmana for the various kinds of auditoriums. Now he is giving us 8 different kinds of measuring units in the from the 13th shloka to the 16th shloka. So let us see. Anu rajasya balasya liksha yuka yuvastadha angulancha tada hasto dandascheyo prakirtitaha. The 8 measuring units are anu, raja, bala, liksha, yuka, yava, angulam, hastam and dandam. Now in the second, the 14th shloka, actually before that, we need to understand what Abhinavagupta says about this. Abhinavagupta says, the paramanu, means that is the atom, is the smallest particle that is available is called the atom. That cannot be seen by the naked eye. Two atoms is called dvyanukam, that dvi anukam means two anus, two atoms. Three are called tyanukam. And six means two tranukam. Six atoms together is something that we can see with the naked eye. This is what Abhinavagupta says. This is all about, don't worry too much about the details because these are all explanations only. Now the measurement units he gives in 14, 15, 16, we'll read the slokas and give the meaning of all the three slokas together. Anavo ashtav rajaproktam tanyashtav bala uchyate balachyashtav bhaver liksha yuka likshashtikam bhavet. Eight anus is equal to one raja. Eight rajas is equal to one bala. Eight balas is equal to one liksha. Eight likshas is equal to one yuka. This is the first sloka. Then the second sloka, the 15th sloka is yuka stvastavu yavo gnyayau yavastvastavu tadha angulam angulani tadha hastaha chaturvimshatiruchyate. Now, eight yukas become one angulam. Don't confuse that with the inch that we have now. This is a word that we have come derived from the English people and their Britain, UK measurements. But that is not the one. That angulam is different. This angulam is different. 24 angulas is one hastam. That is one and a half. You see, in one and a half feet, roughly one and a half feet for a normal human, for a normal human being of a normal size, the arm length, one arm length is called one hastam, which is equivalent to one and a half feet, that means 18 inches. So this angulam, actually for measurement sake, if you look at the British system, 12 inches is equal to 1 foot. But here it is, 18 inches is equal to 1 hastam. And 4 hastams is equal to 1 dandam. That is that we will get it in the next sloka. Chatur hasto bhavet dando nirdishtastu pramanatah anenaiva pramanena vakshyam yasham vinirnayam. So 8 yukas will become 1 yava, 8 angulas, 8 yavas become one angula, 24 angulas will become one hasta, 4 hastas is equal to 1 dandam. So these are the measuring units for the Natya Gruhas. So whenever we use these words, please understand hastam is equal to 18 inches in the modern terminology, which is 1.5 feet. And dandam means 4 hastas, that means equal to almost 6 feet. These two are important. So that is very important. We'll stop there and do the rest of the slokas in the second part. Sloka number 17. Chatushashtikaran kuryat dirghatvenatu mandapam dvatrimshatamcha vistaran matyanam yo bhavediha. Matyana means for human beings. A natya mandapam should have the following measurements. Chatushashtikaran dirghan. Length should be chatushashtikaram, 64 hastas measurement. 64 into 1.5 actually. So that is about 96 feet is the length. Dvatrimshatam cha vistaran. Width should be dvatrimshat. That means 32 hand lengths, hastas. That means 32 plus 16, 48. So 96 is one length, 48 is the width. That should be the measurements of an auditorium for human beings. Now the 18th sloka. Ata urdham na kartavyah kartribhir natyamandapah yasmad avyakta bhavam hi tatra natyam vrajediti. One should not natyamandapam atah urdham na kartavyah. You should not go exceed these limits of measurements. Because yasmad avyakta bhavam hi. If you do that, Natya Pradarshanam will not be clear. Please understand all these prescriptions again and again, I'm repeating, are meant for those days when there is no audio effects, there are no visual effects, there are no lighting sometimes, there are no mics, there are no acoustics, there are no screens sometimes. So that is the 18th sloka. 19th. Mandape viprakrushtetu patya mucharita swaram anisarana dharmatvad visvaratvam brijam brajet. So when you, he talks about the voice modulations. Vikrushta is the largest stage. When you read or sing the text in the ucharita swaram, the voice with which you pronounce a lyric or a dialogue in a huge, biggest auditorium, anistarana dharmatvate vadvi vadvisvaratvam brisham brajet. It becomes, if you want to go out and speak in that voice, it becomes vikrutam. That means it will be very horrible to listen to, and it will also create resound if you use the same voice outside. This voice should be maintained. A particular kind of a modulation and voice are required for the large auditorium. Inside the auditorium, outside you should try to reduce it and speak normally, otherwise it will become horrible, it will also create resound. And the 20th sloka. Yachya pyasya gato bhavo nana drishti samanvitah saveshmanah prakrushtatvat vrajed avyaktatam param. If the natya mandapam is longer in length, then it will not be seen for the audience. He says naveshmanah prakrushtatvat vrajed avyaktatam param. Avyakta means it will not be clear for the audience. If more length is there, it is not clear for the audience what your abhinayam, what is your facial expressions and your abhinayam will not be clear to the audience. Then we go to sloka number 21. Preksha gruhanam sarvesham tasman madhyamishasyate मध्यममिष्यते यावत् पाठ्यं च गायन्ते तत्र श्रव्यतरं भवेत्। इट इज ऑलमोस्ट लाइक अ रिपीटेशन। ही सेज दैट इज वाई प्रेक्षागृहाणां सर्वेषां ऑफ ऑल द ऑडिटोरियम्स मध्यममिष्यते मिडिल लेवल इज द बेस्ट बिकॉज यावत् पाठ्यं च गायन्ते च देयर द टेक्स्ट एंड द लिरिक द डायलॉग्स एंड द सॉन्ग्स तत्र श्रव्यतरं भवेत्। यू नो श्रव्यतरं मीन्स मोर ऑडिबल इन संस्कृत। Like we have white, whiter, whitest, positive, comparative and superlative, we call it in English. Now, Shravyam is positive, Shravyataram is comparative, Shravyatamam is superlative. That is why Taram means comparative, Tamam means superlative. We use this very often in our colloquial language, Tartamam illama pesariyapa. So, without understanding the difference, who is better, who is bigger, who is the best, தெரியாமல் பேசுறது. அந்த மாதிரி தர்த்தமம் மீன்ஸ் தரா இஸ் கம்பேரிட்டிவ் ஸ்ரவ்ய தரம். இட் இஸ் மோர் ஆடிபிள் இஃப் இட் இஸ் மிடில் லெவல் ஆடிட்டோரியம். தட் இஸ் வாட் தி 21 ஸ்லோகஸ் இஸ். வில் டூ தி 22 அண்ட் 23 லிட்டில் லேட்டர் பிகாஸ் தேர் ஆர் டூ மோர் ஸ்லோகாஸ் ஹியர் விச் கம் அண்டர் தி பிராக்கெட்ஸ் ஆஃப்டர் தி 21.